Hi, I'm Caroline from Doodles and Digits. Take a look at these fractions. What do you notice? Something is similar and something is different. What you might notice is that the numerators are all different and the denominators are all different, but they're actually equal to the same thing. Those are called equivalent fractions, and that's what we're gonna get into today.
Doodly-doodle, doodly-doodle, doodly-doodles and digits. Area symmetry fractions too, it's all here for you.
All right, so what are equivalent fractions?
Equivalent fractions are fractions that represent the same value, but actually look a little different. So for example, they have different numerators and denominators.
Why are equivalent fractions useful? Why do we actually need them?
Equivalent fractions are really useful because sometimes when we're solving equations, especially with fractions, it's actually easier to solve them with the same denominator. So let's take this addition problem. If we have the same denominator, we can just add the numerators to get our answer. We can do this if we add, multiply, divide, or subtract. It also is helpful in things like baking, where let's say you don't have the right measuring cup, you can find an equivalent fraction and use that measurement instead.
All right, now that we know what equivalent fractions are, how do we find them? There are actually a few different ways that you can find equivalent fractions. Let's first look at this right here. We're gonna look at some models. What do you notice is going on? That's right, you can actually look at a model and cut it into more pieces to find a different fraction. When you cut that same model into different pieces, you're actually finding an equivalent amount with a different denominator. This is a fraction chart. A fraction chart is a great way to find equivalent fractions and to see how fractions compare to one another. Let's look at this one right here. If we were trying to find a few equivalent fractions to 1/2, what do you notice? Do you see any that are close to 1/2? Do we see any that are exactly 1/2?
1/2 is equivalent to 2/4. It's also equivalent to 3/6. 1/2 is equivalent to 4/8. And finally, 1/2 is equivalent to 6/12. There are so many fractions equivalent to 1/2 on this chart.
All right, now that we have found equivalent fractions to 1/2, can you find a couple equivalent fractions to 1/4?
One-fourth is equivalent to 2/8. 1/4 is also equivalent to 3/12.
Again, a fraction chart is a great way to make math visual so you can actually see what two fractions are the same. You can also find equivalent fractions by multiplying or dividing the numerator and the denominator by the same number. Let's look at this problem right here. So when we look at this fraction, we're gonna multiply the numerator and the denominator by the same number. So let's say 2. We're gonna multiply the numerator by 2 and the denominator by 2. When you multiply the numerator and denominator by the same number, you are actually multiplying by one whole. Look, 2 over 2 is actually 1. So you can multiply by 3 over 3, 4 over 4, you can multiply the top and bottom by 6 over 6. You can also divide the numerator and denominator to get an equivalent fraction. Let's try a few together.
Find an equivalent fraction to 2/5. You can use whatever strategy works best for you. Here are a few answers that you might have gotten. Remember, you could have gotten other ones. Find an equivalent fraction to 4/8. Did you get any of these answers?
How'd you do? Did you get them correct? You can go back and rewatch this video if you ever need a refresher on equivalent fractions. I hope you enjoyed this video. Make sure you like and subscribe if you want more videos just like this one, because we put out new videos every single month.